So where we want to find it is in over here system, because it's empty. So we're going to move this over here. Now why are we doing that? Because now that it's there, we'll have access to it in here. So open. So we have this, sure. But, like I've done before, we can import it. So if we go over here to system, where is it? You'll see icon set. And it's already there. So we already have the icons from this game. But we now have icon set that's already there. So what we're going to do, because we have it, is we're going to open it up. We have iconset.png, and now time for the GIMP. Whatever. I have the GIMP over here. So that's going to take a couple seconds to go through. But what we're going to do is we're going to do a quick and dirty little palette change, basically. Because we need a red booty. Well, I need a red booty. So we're just going to make one. So now that that's done, we're going to go over here. I'm going to slide this over here. We're going to zoom in to about 400%. Well, that's 800, but you know, you get the idea. So we're going to go. This is way too much. There we go. So there, we have booties. So, what I like to do is I'm going to view, snap to grid, show grid. Where is the grid? Where's that grid properties button? I know it's not over here. It should be, but it isn't. Configure grid. Here we go. So, RPG Maker has 32 pixel grids. Apparently not here, doesn't. Oh, was it, Now, I might be lying to you, but I'm fairly certain that it has 32 pixel grids. But, whatever. Configure grid. So, just took a wild guess and changed it to 24, and I was right. But that's only because I've been, like, working with this a lot. So I know what pixels look like. So what we're going to do, because we have it snapped grid, we're going to take the cut tool, we're going to grab these booties right here. Okay, copy it. Go all the way down over here. Go here. Paste it. anchor it. So now we have this pair of booties. We're going to zoom in a little bit more. View, zoom in, 800%. So now we have those booties right there. What we're going to do is we're going to take the color suction tool. We're going to suck up this right there, pencil tool. Now we're going to shrink down our pixel to a single, or our thing to a single pixel, and go like that. There we go. Now we have that, right? And what we're going to do next is grab an eraser. And we need a better hardness on the eraser. So when we click it, it erases the end. So we're just erasing the other boot. We could get in even closer if we really wanted to, and we could do other little tricks. But again, I am wasting a little bit of time while I stall and try to make up stuff. So what we're doing now is we're just going to erase the other boot. So now we just have one boot. And then I'm going to suction this up again, because we accidentally deleted a little bit of that, and just put it there. And then now this is a little bit out of the way, so what we're going to do is just copy that. I'm going to cut, or yeah, control, I can't remember what the cut command is. So yeah, I don't know quick commands, I apologize. We're going to cut, we're going to move it just a little bit so it's a little bit more center, paste, and now we did that, we could move it around. So there we go, and we have a little outline of what we didn't erase. So now that's done, we anchor it. Grab our eraser, go over here, erase that. Now, Santa's boots have a pretty red and white color scheme. So let's go to white. And, oh, we're still on the eraser. So, there we go. Now we have a rim of a boot. We need some dark red inside of the boot. So just, guess it. We're gonna just replace a couple of these darker red, or the darker browns, with darker reds. And then an even darker red for the even darker parts. Right, and then on the outside we need a lighter red, so let's call that this red. So we can make this even easier by grabbing the bucket fill tool. I don't use this very, very often, so forgive me for not knowing immediately what the hotkeys and where everything is. You're just gonna have to cope with it. So, the bucket fill that, there we go. Now, what other colors look like that one? So, bucket fill here, 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 There we go. Now we need a slightly lighter red. So, slightly lighter. The slightly lighter will go here. Here. Right, there, why not? Now, even lighter red. So even lighter red, we'll go there, there, there. Now, this is almost pink red. That will go there. And just have fun with it, right? We're making a booty. See, we kind of screwed that up. Well, I kind of screwed that up. That's what the Control Z is for, right? Go back, do that really light pink. Let's get some more reds in there. Let's grab that really light pink again. And let's put it here. There. Now, you can make up your own color palette if you're better at art than I am. I'm just kind of lazy, so I need a good color, and I made one. So, I just want to fill in all the browns with the pinks and reds that we just made. Just to make this booty look like a Christmas booty. Let's make the brightest, darkest red over here for the very tip of the boot. Let's put it into a couple of these other spots here. And then copy that. And boop. There we go. We have a Christmas booty. Well, that's done. We save it. Now, we don't save it here, sadly. Even though we opened it up there, we export it. Now, when we looked at it, it was a... what type of file? It was a PNG. So, in here, we file. Export. Iconset.png to that place, so export. Yes, replace it. Done. Export. So now, we look in here. We go in here. And we have a booty. So there we go. We have a booty for our stocking stuffer.